So when we look up at the night sky, sometimes we get really lucky and we can see the bright band of the Milky Way stretching across the sky. And the reason why it looks like this to us on Earth is because we live in the Milky Way galaxy, which is actually a huge collection of stars and dust all gravitationally bound together in this disk shape. So our sun is one of those stars. And when we're looking up at the sky from Earth, we're actually looking through the plane of the spiral disk. So we're seeing lots of bright spots and also lots of dark, dusty streaks. Now, the Milky Way is a spiral galaxy, but that's not the only kind of galaxy there is. Broadly speaking, we can divide galaxies into three different classes. There are spheroid galaxies, which are round and generally appear to be pretty smooth. There are disk galaxies, which are sort of rotating and flat, and they tend to have more structure to them, like these spiral arms that you can see here. And then there's irregular galaxies, which don't really fit into either category. They can be kind of disorganized looking, and they can take on a variety of appearances. So the reason why galaxy shape matters is because the shape is the result of everything that's happened to that galaxy in the past. So how it was initially formed, how it's interacted with other galaxies or supermassive black holes throughout its lifetime, and how quickly it's forming new stars today. Surveying galaxies is a major tool of observational astronomy. For example, when the Hubble Space Telescope launched in 1990, that was one of its major goals, to look at all of the galaxies across the universe. You may have seen pictures of deep space like this one that Hubble took, and now everything in this image, aside from a few foreground stars, is a galaxy. Astronomers have combed through images like this one in order to classify every object that they can see to better understand how galaxies form and evolve. And as you can imagine, that would take a really long time. That problem is about to get even worse because a new telescope, the Vera Rubin Observatory, is currently being built and it may see first light as early as later this year. This telescope will have the largest digital camera ever built for astronomy. To view a single photograph from this camera, you would need 1,500 high-definition TV screens. And every night, 20 terabytes of data, that's 20,000 gigabytes, will need to be processed and stored. So scientists are starting to grapple with how to deal with this huge amount of data, and they need all the help they can get. And to that end, a team of researchers at the University of California, Santa Cruz has developed a computer program to help automatically classify galaxies by their shape or morphology, which is why it's called Morpheus. So they started with a data set called the GOODS Collaboration. It stands for Great Observatories Origins Deep Survey, and it includes the Hubble data we just saw, along with lots and lots of other astronomical images all pieced together into this patchwork or mosaic. And the goal was to go from this raw astronomical image to a map of galaxies. And here you can see that Morpheus, the program, has identified this big galaxy in the middle as a disk galaxy, which I would agree with because I think I see some spiral arms in there. And it's also picked out several spheroid galaxies in red, more disk galaxies in blue, some irregular galaxies in green, and then also some yellow point source objects, which are actually stars. So how did they do this? In order to get a computer program to recognize galaxies on its own, they turned to a kind of artificial intelligence called neural networks. And these are programs that are really good at recognizing patterns, and they're built on principles that are meant to mimic how our own brains recognize images. So they would start with the image that they want to classify galaxies in, the input image, and then they would divide it up into lots of little pieces, little pixel patches, just a few pixels at a time, and feed each of those patches into the neural network. And the first thing that it's going to do is search each of those little patches and look for just the simplest pattern possible, just edges. And it'll round up all of that information about where the edges are and pass it to another layer of processing to look for very slightly more complicated features. And then it'll round up that information and pass it on again and again through many layers of processing, building up more and more complicated features as it goes along. Until in the last layer, it can spit out its best guess at where different types of galaxies are present in the original image. Now, the first time they built it, it probably didn't do a very good job right off the bat because neural networks need to be trained. So they need to be shown lots of examples of what they're looking for in order to get better over time. So luckily, the GOODS collaboration that they started with is a very special data set because scientists have already gone through it and identified all of the galaxies in there. So the scientists could show Morpheus lots and lots of examples of when it was getting it right and when it was getting it wrong, and that way it could improve itself and learn over time. That's the advantage of neural networks. They're fast learners. So I'm just going to show you a little video now from the team of Morpheus classifying a group of galaxies that it's never seen before. You're going to see over here on the left this little yellow box moving from left to right and then up the image as it scans pixel by pixel. And then over on the right, as it's doing that, you'll see the galaxy map being built up over time, also pixel by pixel. So I'll start that right now. The boxes that you're seeing in the middle are showing as for each pixel that the box passes over, it's showing how well that fits into each of the galaxy types. So spheroid, disk, a regular galaxy, a point source or a star, or is it part of the background? And it runs for a little while, so I'll skip to the end so you can see how Morpheus has filled in and classified all of the different blobs in this image. This is really important because astronomers can really speed up their processing of new data, and it's already available to the public. You can start using it right now, and we know that it's doing the right thing because we have existing data to compare it to. So armed with Morpheus, we now can get a better handle on galaxy classification and hopefully improve our understanding of the universe.